Bizzibox's expert information on Chinese herbs. How are Chinese herb formulations prepared?
When you make a diagnosis in terms of herbal medicine, it's the same diagnosis that you would use whether you were going to treat with acupuncture or herbal medicine or Tuina massage, any other form of treatment in Chinese medicine. The diagnosis is the same. It doesn't quite sound like a Western diagnosis, a different system of medicine, different way of approaching things. Then, once you've got your diagnosis, if you're going to make up a herbal prescription, you make a prescription that balances the flavours and balances the tastes of the herbs and the actions of the herbs, almost like making a picture. I often think Chinese medicine is like a picture. If I were to paint a painting of my friend, what I would paint would be something very different from what somebody else would paint. It's not that that picture is wrong that I'm painting or that she is painting, it's that it's different. And what I'm trying to do is to get a representation of that person I'm painting as closely as I can. I'm representing what I'm seeing. In Chinese medicine, that's what you're doing. So with a herbal prescription, you're doing something very similar to that. It sounds quite nebulous. It's not. It's very precise and very clear. And the herbs are measured in grams, and they have to be boiled in the most particular way. The interactions of the herbs are very tightly controlled.
What can Chinese herbs treat?
Herbal medicine can treat all internal conditions. But in the West, it's more often used to treat conditions where perhaps conventional Western medicine maybe doesn't do it as well. So often you'll find patients coming for gynecological conditions, female problems. So we often treat infertility, for example. There's a lot of people these days suffer from infertility, and they find Chinese medicine is hugely valuable, really, really effective. Also, all other types of female problems are very well treated with herbal medicine. All types of period pains, menopausal problems, the whole range. But also there are other areas that specifically are very responsive to herbal medicine, particularly dermatology, anything to do with skin conditions, where the diagnosis in Chinese medicine is very, very precise, much more precise than it is in conventional medicine. And because that differentiation is very precise, the herbal medicine can be used either internally or externally as a lotion or a balm, and it treats very effectively. I suppose the third area that I would immediately think of where Chinese herbal medicine has a particularly strong part to play is in emotional conditions. Everything, really, from simply stress conditions like things like insomnia, for example, through depression. A lot of people these days suffer from depression, right the way through to the more complex labels. So, for example, things like schizophrenia, bipolar disorder, all those kind of things can be treated very effectively with Chinese medicine, and especially Chinese herbal medicine.
What ingredients are in Chinese herbs?
The ingredients of Chinese herbal medicine are very wide. If you look at traditional Chinese medicine in China, you'll probably see somewhere between 2,000 and 10,000 different products. Plants, mostly, but also animal products and mineral products that are used for herbal medicine. In this country, you would see a much reduced herbal materia medica. And mostly, in fact, almost exclusively, these will be plant-based because of the way we view things in this country and because of the political climate, but also because we wouldn't in any case want to be using endangered species. So those things are banned, but just to let people know that they are out there, but that if they were to go to a Chinese herbal medicine practitioner in this country, they won't see any banned products, and quite rightly, Operation Charm in this country deals with that kind of thing and makes sure that that doesn't happen. So mostly what you would find is plant-based products. For instance, this one, which is called Daoren, which is peach kernels, which smells just lovely. Unfortunately, you can't smell that, but they look and smell gorgeous, like almonds, very, very intense almond smell. And all parts of plants and trees are used right the way from the roots deep in the earth to the bark, the resin, the seeds, the branches, the twigs, the leaves, the whole bit.
Who are the best candidates for Chinese herb treatment?
Anybody is a good candidate for treatment. We all get sick. This is a system of medicine that treats everybody and all conditions, much like Western medicine does. So you can't look at a person and say they're a good or a poor candidate. What you can say, based on experience of treating them, that they may respond better, for example, to trina, or better to acupuncture, or better to herbal medicine. And certain conditions are likely to respond better. For example, dermatological conditions, anything to do with the skin, you would be much more likely to use herbal medicine than you would acupuncture, for instance, or trina. Whereas if you've got a sprain or a strain, you would probably use either acupuncture or trina.
Who should avoid Chinese herb treatment?
Chinese medicine can treat anybody. It's not a type of treatment that you should think, oh, this category of person should avoid it. They shouldn't. Your practitioner will know if a particular sort of treatment isn't suitable for your particular condition. But as to broad categories of people who should avoid it, there aren't any.
Are Chinese herbs safe?
Any Chinese herbal medicine is likely to be safer than any drug that you will take. There are occasionally stories in the press about a particular herb. This has nearly always been prescribed by somebody who wasn't properly trained. Almost always you see that either the patient took it without the guidance of a practitioner, or they took it with the guidance of a practitioner who wasn't well enough trained. I can't stress strongly enough how important it is to go to somebody who has got the proper credentials. It takes usually 5 years to train to be a Chinese medicine herbalist. It's not appropriate to go to somebody who doesn't have membership of a bona fide professional body, such as the Register of Chinese Herbal Medicine.
Are there any risks with Chinese herbs?
When you're looking at a herb such as this, what you're looking at is the entirety of the plant. The way a herb is used, that piece of the plant is used on its own. Nothing is done to it other than that it's dried. If, for example, to make a comparison, you're looking at a drug, the active ingredient of the product is taken to make the drug, and it's extracted and potentized and strengthened and strengthened and strengthened, that one component of it. To get the similar amount of that active component in a herb, you would need to take this much of the herb. So the chances of there being a problem with herbal medicine are greatly reduced compared with most other systems of medicine. However, that isn't to say that it couldn't happen. Yes, it could. There are certain conditions that you need to be sure that, for example, you need to be sure that the patient's liver can deal with the herbal medicine. There are tests to make sure of this, and your practitioner will make sure that that happens. If you're taking something that might impact on liver or kidneys, the practitioner will watch that very carefully.
What do Chinese herbs look like?
Chinese herbs are very pretty, very attractive. They're very, very earthy colours, and they have very appealing shapes, and they often smell really lovely.
What do Chinese herbs taste like?
The taste of Chinese herbs is often very strong. That's people's primary impression of them. Sometimes bitter, sometimes fragrant, that is to say, very kind of sweet, almost a bit cloying, sometimes sour. They're not best sold as lovely tasting things. However, from personal experience, what I find is that when I'm taking a prescription to start with, I think, oh my goodness. And then as time goes on and I take more and more of it, I somehow become attuned to that to the point where I actually like it. And when you first take it, that's hard to imagine, but it does get to the point where you really like them.
Can I have Chinese herbs if I am a vegetarian?
As to whether you can have Chinese herbs as a vegetarian, you certainly can. There's nothing animal in them.
What form can Chinese herbs be taken in?
The traditional form is like this. It's in a form that you would recognise as obviously plant-based. So it looks like twigs, or it looks like seeds, or it looks like leaves. Much more common, actually, particularly in Hong Kong and China, are the herbal tablet form, which is a lot easier to take. It doesn't taste anything like as strong, and it's much more straightforward. You don't have to boil it up, obviously. You can just take them straight after meals or whatever. Also, there are other forms, which is powdered herbs. So you're using these herbs, but they're powdered, and then they come in little capsules, horse capsules, that people can take much more readily also than the liquid version.
How much would I expect to pay for Chinese herbs?
In terms of cost for Chinese herbal medicine, you need to think that there will probably be a consultation fee. The average is probably about £20 for a consultation fee. The herbs will normally be on top. And the way the herbs are charged for is with relation to the number of bags. It's nearly always per bag. So to explain what I mean, you would, if you're taking this kind of herb, it would be made up into a prescription for a day. You boil that much up per day and you drink the decoction. Well, that costs a certain amount per bag. You might have a week's worth. So, I don't know, probably anything from £3 to £7 a bag is normal.
www.bizzybox.com